news booming. We had many inventions, and they didn't seem to have an end. Elias Howe invented a sewing machine that helped clothing makers sew dozens of clothes faster than what could be done by hand. Elias Howe wasn't the only person who increased production in the field of work. Many others did, too. John Deere, for example, invented a lightweight steel plow. These plows could be pulled by horses instead of previously used slow oxen. John Deere wasn't the only inventor who created something for farming. Cyrus McCormick opened a factory that created mechanical reapers. I was stunned to see the amount of progress farmers started to make in a day. The reapers outworked 5 workers. Samuel F.B. Morse was the inventor I envied the most of anybody. His invention was an instant success. With the telegraph, people could now send messages to each other over extremely long distances. The Congress was so excited about his invention, they gave him the funds to do it. Telegraph companies were everywhere. Another man named John Griffiths launched the first of the clipper ships. It was called the Raymond. These clipper ships broke every speed record. They sped past older ships on their ways to specific destinations. It was no wonder they were fast with those huge sails of theirs. Even though all these great things were happening, people still felt insecure about them. I personally thought they were great, but there's always that one person, I guess. Thus began the race between Tom Thumb, a steam-powered locomotive, and a regular old horse. Of course, with all these great inventions, there had to be a downside. Factories replaced workshops, leaving many without jobs. You could work for a factory, but things were getting dangerous. I even heard a story of trade unions were created to fight for better rights in the workplace, but the unskilled workers were left out. Immigrants brought many new cultures with them as they came for jobs. Many people protested. My own opinion, though, remains that some of these cultures will be good for future workers.